Good morning everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I'm working on a still life. I have picked a beautiful vase of flowers from my garden and I'm working on one element at a time, being the vase of roses. Showing you how I commence work by sketching in the composition first with some pastels, then painting in the main composition of the roses and vase by blocking in the subject matter with paint. So here we go. I hope you enjoy. So I've outlined the vase and now I'm just sketching in what I can see in the way of the roses and the petals, very loosely. Trying not to take my pastel off the canvas, and just watching the roses as I actually do the sketching. It's very hard to talk and to concentrate on what you're doing at the same time, but we'll get there. So I've decided to use a little bit of ink on this canvas board and I wasn't really sure whether it would take or not, but it seems to be okay. So it'll probably get hidden later under paint, but I'm just going to go for it and see what the effects are. One thing about painting, it's really good to sort of experiment, because you never know what effect you're going to get and how it's all going to pan out for you. And you might get something really, really nice just by trying something different. As you can see, the Jane Devonport inks that I'm using are actually running because I've got the board standing upright, so you would half expect that to happen. I'm not sure about the effect on the board, whether I really like it or not. So this is what I'm using. So it's just ink straight out of the model. Going to continue blocking in the rest of the painting. I'll squirt water on the canvas and it's made the paint go very runny. Well, the painting's dry, so now I'm going to, I finished blocking in, so now I'm going to start bringing in some more details. Okay, so I've mixed a few colours up on my palette on the table, different reds and greens and things. So I have blocked in a bit more darker colour into the leaves and stems. So now I'm going to start concentrating on the actual flowers themselves. Starting off with a little bit of a deeper colour in the centre of each rose. Starting from dark to light, and then I'll make my way out to the lighter colours. I'm also going to outline the vase a bit more. Quite a heavy set of crystal vibes in the painting, so I've minded the lines go a little bit thicker. Okay, so I'm about to put the succulents into the little pot, very loosely. I didn't get enough paint on my brush. Maybe not that one. I'm just going to do some stems. They're all sort of higgly-piggly. I think my cat's been chewing on the plant, so it might not be looking too healthy. Thank you. just adding in the couple of petals that have fallen off the roses onto the tabletop. You're a bit deeper in colour because it actually fallen off the rose and died. So now I'm just putting a few little stamens inside the roses. So I've painted the petals, I'm just letting them to dry because I would like to put another coat on. And in the meantime, I'm just adding a little bit of shadow for the roses to give them a little bit more contrast. I'm just using a watercolour gel pastel to add in the shadows. You can put water on these gel pastels. I thought it'd be easier just to do this. Okay, so I've made the petals and I've painted them. I'm trying to make them as realistic as I can. I had them this big, but I had to cut them down due to the fact scale wasn't right on the painting, so I want it to look more realistic. So I'll pop one in there and one sort of fallen there, and I'm going to adhere them with some Liquitex glass medium. It's a transparent glue. So I'm glazing them onto the board, I'm just putting a very light coat over the top. And then I'm just going to dab some of this around the glazing medium. It'll dry clear just to give a little bit of shine, another dimension. So if you like this video and you want to see more, please press the like button and subscribe. I'm trying to put a video out once a week on a Monday. A bit later on, I probably will give this a spray to seal the canvas and it'll be done. This painting will fit into an A size frame, and all my paintings are available to buy. You can contact me via Facebook or Instagram if you're interested. Make a lovely Christmas present. Anyway, stay tuned and more videos will be coming your way.